Okay, in today's video, I'm going over single replacement reactions.
A single replacement reaction is when a single element replaces a second element in a compound. So you can see here's the general form for a single replacement reaction. Here's our single element, our lone element all by itself. And that single element is going to replace a second element. Here's the second element B. And here in that second element is in this compound BX. So what happens basically is A, the single element kicks B out, and then we have another single element and then a compound on the product side. So I think the easiest way to recognize a single replacement reaction is if you have a single element or a lone element and a compound on both sides of your chemical equation. So we have A and BX, and then on our product side, we also have a single element and a compound. So on each side, we have a single element and a compound. There are two different kinds of single replacement reactions. We have cation replacement and anion replacement. Cations are our positively charged ions, are metals. So we have a metal replacing a metal. So here the zinc is our single element. It replaces the second element, copper. And therefore we're going to have copper by itself. The zinc kicks the copper out, and then we have zinc chloride. Anion single replacement. We have our anions are our negatively charged, our nonmetals. So the bromine here is going to kick out the iodine, and then we're going to have iodine by itself, and then we're going to have potassium bromide. Okay, so once again, we have a single element and a compound on both sides of the chemical equation. All right, let's go through and see if we can identify some and predict the products and then come up with the balanced equations for these single replacement reactions. Okay, so the first one, we have a cation, in this case it's a metal, and then we have hydrogen, which is not a metal, but also forms a positive charge, so that's our cation, so this is cation single replacement reaction. The zinc is going to kick out the hydrogen, and that is going to give us hydrogen gas, which is simply H2, and then we're gonna have zinc chloride, and zinc chloride is Zn, and the zinc is a positive 2 charge, the chlorine is a minus 1, so it's ZnCl2. And let's see if we can balance that. We have two hydrogens on the right, so then we're going to have two hydrogens on the left. We have two chlorines, and we have one zinc on each side, and that is the balanced single replacement reaction for zinc and hydrochloric acid. This is a fun reaction to do because you can capture this hydrogen gas in a balloon. And then because hydrogen gas is flammable, you can light that hydrogen gas on fire and that gives you a nice big explosion. All right, so that was good. And let's go on to the next one. Now we have anion single replacement. And here is our anion. We can tell this is a nonmetal. And we have another nonmetal here. So the chlorine is gonna kick out the bromine in our compound. And that's gonna give us Br2, another diatomic gas. And then we're gonna have plus sodium chloride. Oopsie daisy, what am I doing here? Sodium chloride is NaCl. Sodium is a plus 1, chlorine is a minus 1, so it looks like that. And then we have two bromines over here, which means we're going to need to put a 2 here. And then I'm going to ignore my little scribble there, and I'm going to put a 2 there in front of that one. So that is the balanced single replacement reaction for chlorine and sodium bromide. Okay, and let's see, I think that's all balanced out like that. Okay, so now we have the next one. We have a copper, we have aluminum and copper. So those are our two metals, so that we know this is gonna be a cation replacement. So the aluminum is gonna replace the copper. And before we do that, I'm actually gonna go through and show you this single replacement reaction, do a little demo for you. So let's go and
do okay, so now we're gonna do a single replacement reaction between copper, chloride, and aluminum. Here I have a piece of aluminum. It's just plain aluminum foil. This is what my copper chloride looks like when I get it out of the storeroom. It says right there, cupric chloride. It's CuCl2. And I dissolved some in water, soluble in water. So I dissolved in water, and that is my test tube that has the copper chloride solution, copper and chlorine in aqueous solution. And I'm just simply going to take the aluminum and put it right into the copper chloride solution, and let's see what happens. You'll notice that nothing is happening at first, but then you'll notice it starts to bubble right away. I'm going to take it out quickly and just show you. Perhaps you can see. Okay, so that's what it looks like after it's reacted for just a few seconds there, as you saw. And a lot of my students say, oh, that looks like poop, but it's not poop. And maybe what is that brown stuff that's on there? So let's just put it back in here. And it's quite a vigorous reaction. It gets hot. It's an exothermic reaction. And you can see that the aluminum actually is being replaced pretty quickly by the copper. And if I push it down too far, it'll come out the top. And if I hold it too far down, it gets kind of hot. But you can see that reaction occurs pretty quickly. Sometimes I'll just put it in a beaker like this so that I can hold it. And that's single replacement reaction between aluminum and copper chloride. And I'll take the aluminum out. You can see the aluminum out. All right, that's the brown stuff. What is that brown stuff that's on there? Well, let's see. Maybe we have some with us. I'm going to open my wallet. And you'll see, oh, look, I have some right here. Here's one that I let run for a little while. And let's look at this one. Here's one that I did a couple days ago. Here's the water level up here. I have my aqueous solution, and here in the bottom I have copper, and you'll notice it looks just like my copper pendant because that is pure copper on the bottom of my test tube there. Okay? So that's
single replacement. Okay, I think that's, that's not an explosion or a big flash or anything like that, but I think that's kind of a cool single replacement reaction. You can see that reaction is kind of a nice and vigorous reaction. You see it happens pretty quickly. So we know we're going to have the aluminum and the copper. Aluminum is our single element. And the copper chloride is our compound, so the aluminum is going to kick the copper out. So we're going to have copper now by itself, and then we're going to have plus aluminum chloride, and aluminum forms a plus 3 charge, and chlorine forms a minus 1 charge, so we know it's going to be AlCl3, and we have 3 chlorines on this side, and 2 over here, so we have 3 and 2. We know we're going to put a 3, so we can have 6 of each, and then we're going to put 2 here. That gives us 2 aluminums. So we know we're going to need 2 aluminums. And we put a 3, so we had 3 coppers. So now we have to have 3 coppers on this side like that. Okay, so I think that's the balanced single replacement, cation replacement for aluminum and copper chloride. All right, now we got one more. We got another metal and a metal, so we're going to have another cation replacement. The metal is going to kick the metal out. And for this reaction too, I'm going to show you this reaction here before we go through
now
and
figure out the products. I'm going to do another single replacement reaction, our second single replacement reaction. And for this reaction, we are going to have a reaction between magnesium metal and silver nitrate. I have a metal bottle lid here. I put some silver nitrate and some magnesium in, and I'm going to add a little water, some little activation energy to get the reaction going, and we'll see how this one works out. Okay, so here we go. Don't blink. If you blink, you'll miss it. Okay, that one is a pretty vigorous exothermic reaction, and you can see you get a lot of sparks and a lot of heat out of that, okay? But that is a single replacement reaction between magnesium metal and
silver. Okay, that works out really well. That's a nice bright flash of light. Get a little noise out of that one, so students always like that one. That's a fun one. You can do that right in class also. Okay, so now we have single replacement. The magnesium is going to kick out the silver. So now we're going to have silver by itself, and then we're going to have magnesium nitrate, and once again, magnesium forms a plus 2 charge, the nitrate forms a minus 1 charge, so it's going to be MgNO3, and then we're going to need 2 of those to satisfy that one magnesium. So we have 2 nitrates. That tells us we're going to have 2 here. So we have 2 nitrates, but now we have 2 silvers, so now we're going to have 2 here. And I think that's 1 magnesium on both sides. Okay, so there we go. That is a single replacement reaction between magnesium and silver nitrate. I think we got all those taken care of. You can see on each case, single replacement reaction, lone element compound on both sides of that chemical equation. So there you go. I hope that was helpful. And we'll see you next time.